come up here behind the head. You don't want to miss this meat that's up here. Then you just put your knife in and follow right around behind the dorsal fin, come out the belly. You just feel down until you find the rib cage. I'll show you that in a minute. Now here I'm about halfway down and I can go on through and come out next to the anus. Now I'm going to just cut down to the tail. I'm not going to go clear through. But what I like to do so you don't miss this belly meat is come back and make a cut right up to the rib cage, just like that. You can feel I'm up against the rib cage there. And then just bring your knife right on up. And I've just made that cut all the way up to the rib cage. Now I'm just going to follow that up and over, just letting the knife feel the ribs all the way. And when you get here, it's going to feel real tight here. Now there I did pick up one rib, but you've got to kind of cut through the kind of a little hard area here, that there's a few tiny bones right there that you've got to cut through, and those will cook up. You can cut them out if you choose to, but you just follow right down the belly. And so there's what we did. We made our incision here behind the head, cut down to the belly, then we come in here and the knife is following right along, right up to the rib cage. That first cut doesn't have to be all the way up. It can be like so. And then what I did was I knifed through here. I did catch a couple ribs, but and then come on down to the tail. Then I turn the knife back over, come back up, and make this cut here, because it's real easy to lose a lot of meat right in this area. So then I come back up and cut right up to the rib cage, then come up and over and just keep knifing and lifting that back. Okay, now we've got the fillet here on the skin. So we're just going to let this skin do the work for us instead of taking it off and having to put a clamp it onto a board like many of them that they sell. You can just go right in here and start your cut. That's still attached. Then just lay your finger on there and make a few light cuts, not too much pressure down, not too much pressure forward. Doesn't have to be all in one cut. But there you have just a beautiful bluegill fillet. So anyway, now we'll, you can see here that put them right on ice. Always keep your fillets nice and cold. And I like to work on newspaper. It's real easy. I peel one off every so often. Okay, now here, I'm going to cut in behind the head again. There's a real hard bone right in back here, and so that's what we're going in, is behind this hard bone and right down behind the pectoral fins. And I like to work fairly close to the edge of my table. It makes it a lot easier if you can have your knife down right off the edge. So now we're going to go down, cut through, down to the base, back up to the belly, around the ribs, lay it open. Okay, now here we're coming through the little bit of fine rib bones there. This one, likes to pick up that last rib. And it doesn't have to be perfect, it never is. And some guys are a lot better than others at it. But the main thing is that it's always nice to do your own. I like boneless fillets. And just like that, you can cut that. I like to cut it here for one piece of fillet, cut it here for another, and then cut this into the fourth piece. So a nice bluegill like this, you'll get four nice pieces of meat out of. You just take that and fold it over. What this does is it keeps your work surface dry. If you work like on a tabletop, stainless steel, even wood, and I like wood second best to paper, it's gonna get slick from the fish right in on the ice. What I like to do is stir them up after a bit, get them down in the ice.